It's been said that the way you see the problem is the problem. Could it be that the realities that you have experienced and are experiencing is because of the way you perceived what you saw? Well, I speak healing and clarity in your mind's sight, and I challenge you to a perspective check.
Hi everyone, this is Sandra Garcon Dujarville. I hope you guys are having a great week. I wanted to pop in for our new perspective check video, and this week I wanted to kind of sum up what we talked about last night on the Facebook Live because we kicked off our new series on loving love right. And last night we were talking about original love. And so I worked on laying that foundation for love and understanding what love is. And so next week we're going into bipolar love, then schizophrenic love, and reckless love. And so I just wanted to kind of share the definition that we use for love comes from good therapy, and it says it's a mix of emotions, behaviors, and beliefs associated with a strong feeling of affection, protectiveness, warmth, and a respect for another person. So what it's saying about love is not just that it's an emotion, it affects the behavior. And not just, and the reason it can affect the behavior because it deals with the core belief system of the person. And so is the strong feelings of emotion that or affection that provides protectiveness. So within love, love protects. It gives us warmth. So we're all into this warmth and this ooey gooey piece, and that's important, but that's not all there is to love. And love provides respect. So in the DNA of love is protectiveness, is the warmth and the ooey gooeyness, and is definitely respect for one another. And then in addition to that, last night we also talked about the four types of love. One, which is agape love, and that is a choice to love God, to love your neighbor, to accept yourself without expecting something. So that is giving love just because that's who you are, just because it's within you, not because this person has to do XYZ in order to justify or qualify for me to give them love. The people in our lives will not always be worthy of love in terms of what they do in their behavior. So we got to extend it anyways. As a parent, my son don't always do the right things, but that has nothing to do with me loving him. You know, and then so you have feel your love, which is refers to an esteem and affection, refers to esteem and affection reflected in the loving concern for friends, that friends have for one another. And so that is helping develop healthy relationship and friendship. We got to go back to the definition of friendship. There are people that we have in our lives that we call friends. They are not friends because they do not fit the criteria of friends. So we have to be able to vet people to make sure they are worthy to be in our life or worthy to be called a friend. You know, and then there's Eros love, and Eros love is dealing with the appetite of self-centered love, sexual desires, and things of that nature. That's really great within the boundaries of marriage, you know. And then Storge, and Storge deals with the affection for family members, our affection and our love and care for them. You know, we didn't get to choose who we have as our family. God did not give us that choice because if He did, we would not have made the correct choice. Now, being a counselor, I've worked for years with clients who have family members that honestly, the way that they've loved each other, no, I would not ever choose this. But I believe every single relationship, healthy or unhealthy, demonstrates something that you can glean from, that you can correct in your own life. And so the types of relationship that we're attracting sometimes is a reflection of the things and the issues that are in our own life that we need to check. And if we check those issues, a lot of the difficulties or the problems that we have around relationships and even with family relationships, sometimes our family members don't love us right. And them not loving us right is not always intentional. Sometimes they just don't know how to love. We don't always know how to love. Because love requires a level of maturity and self-discipline, self-sacrifice, that some of us just, we just never know. We've never been taught that way. We've just only thought love was just about how you make me feel, and it's not. And so another thing that we end up talking about is the scripture of love. And if you're going to talk about love, you cannot not talk about God, because he is the originator of love. You know, so we want to make sure that we get from him what was his intention for creating love. Because when he sends love out to us in heaven, from heaven, it's pure. But when that love, that pure love hits our lives, it goes through the tunnels of our brokenness, of our trauma, of our pain, and it causes us to now issue out to people that we do love and care about and want in our life. It causes us to issue out brokenness to them, a love that is deformed or a love that is perverted. Perversion is not always some nasty, you know, kind of thing. Perversion is the deformation of something. So the purity of love is designed to cover and protect and show respect. When it comes out deformed. And so when we go next week into bipolar love and schizophrenic love, we're going to be addressing some of this deformation of love so that we can get healed and delivered. So the scripture is 1 Corinthians 13. Chapter 13, verses 4 through 8. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy, love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things, and love never fails. So these are characteristics or boundaries in which love can appropriately operate. Outside of these things, love does not have, it's kind of like when, if I'm a farmer and I'm planting a crop, and so I don't put good soil, so my crop is not being planted on good soil, it makes it so difficult for me to get a harvest, for the street to grow, and if it does grow, it's not as healthy as it could have been because of the unhealthiness of the soil. So if you're going to have a healthy crop of love in your life, God says in the soil of your life, these are the things that you need to develop so that love can have all the nutrients it needs to grow and to develop. I hope that blessed you. I felt blessed by it. And so I just am so thankful and so grateful. And I look forward to talking more with you guys next Monday night. Okay, next Monday night as we continue this series on loving love right. Because next week we are getting into bipolar love. All right. So we're about to uncover some craziness in love. So I'll see you next Monday. Be blessed. Share this video. Please share this video. All right.